Hey there, guys. SC Mothership checking in along with
SC Investor.
So, we got a game here on Zelnaga Caverns. We've got Ryugu here spawning as the blue Zerg. And we got Link of Shadow saying good luck and have fun to his opponent. Link of Shadow obviously spawning as the red Protoss on the northwestern position, and Ryugu spawning as the spawning in the northeastern position, Ryugu spawning in the southwestern position. And the map is Zelnaga Caverns.
Just a quick update, you guys, if you haven't checked out the other video series, we have in fact started up two new series. The Mothership's Vortex of Customs, which is just when Mothership reviews several custom games, and myself, I have started uploading my odd jobs. And if you just want to listen to a comedic series of me and my friend doing really weird builds, then go ahead and check that out.
Yeah, Dylan's pretty funny, man. But, yeah, and the only game I got actually uploaded right now of the MVC is the Desert Strike, but actually my computer crashes in that video.
I know. I watched until the end.
Really?
Yeah, Paveway there. I'm commentating the rest of the game.
Yeah, so you kind of... But yeah, it's actually pretty fun. That was actually an interesting game. That guy kind of bad bannered me. Or was banned. Oh, and that probe actually blocking the placement.
Yeah, stopping that placement. Not seeing anything unusual from either of the players at this point of the game. So... Yeah. Right now, as of now, I'd say it looks pretty standard.
Yep, Link of Shadow in that first gas. Probably going to be seeing some sort of 3-gate opening. It's pretty common for Zergs to actually do some sort of Roach Ling all-in on this map. Because if we just take a quick look here at the natural of both players, if you with these two channels of attacks, if Roaches try and come in from one angle, just like right there, a Protoss will force field off, and then the Lings can run behind here, making it much either running into the main or surrounding the army and sentries, so they can be very difficult for any Protoss to hold off a Roachling all in. So you'll oftentimes see players expand later on this map just because of the fear of something like that. Actually, gas
Whoa,
field.
Yeah. Nice.
Yeah, gas field going down by Rugu, so it is going to delay the any sort of sentry amounts that could be coming out of Link of Shadow.
Just a quick question here. One gate cyber, does that mean that they're trying to rush warp gates?
No, this is actually pretty standard here. Nothing out of the usual coming out of Link of Shadow.
That was Zerg doing an extractor trick.
Although we are seeing a Chronoboost going out on the warp gate, so what I meant to say is it's not having that cybernetic core at that timing was not indicative of any sort of a quick gate strategy, but we might actually be seeing we haven't seen any halted probe production. Now if probe production halts here, be a 4-gate, but actually a stalker coming out of that warp gate too, so I'm actually really curious to see what Link of Shadow has planned here. That one probe just
blocking off that Ling, yeah. Just making sure the Zerg can't really see anything in here, yep. But I don't think you would be seeing that much in here. Let's take a look at the production tabs already up. We're seeing two queens, so one from this hatchery and one from this hatchery. Triple queen is pretty good because it's your only anti-air support for early game, and they're gonna be having one queen dedicated to spreading creep, which is really easy to do on this map because you have two central paths.
Okay, so I do know what Link of Shadow is planning to do now. Getting that first stalker out actually is a pretty big sign. He's actually gonna be going for some sort of blink stalker play here. So, but he's gonna need that second gas now. I'm surprised he hasn't thrown it down yet.
Just haven't panned the camera there yet. Whoa, we're seeing 5-gate. Oh no, that's just Twilight Council.
Yeah, it's actually gonna be a 4-gate blink all in. So, it's gonna be a very, very, now 5 gates going down. So this is very, very all in. I wouldn't be expecting to see Link of Shadow do any sort of expansion here. It's gonna be quite interesting.
Can you run a one base and pump out stalkers? I don't think so. You'd need too much Vespine for that with 5 gateways.
Yeah, so what his plan here is to just basically get one full warp in of blink stalkers, and that's pretty much going to be... this is weird now. This just got really trippy. Are we seeing 5-gate DT?
DTs? Why would it...
Because there's a Dark Shrine going down right now.
Where's that? Oh!
Right where you just clicked on.
I don't know if this is gonna work because he's been set back gas, and talking about gas, Zerg hasn't taken gas at all, and really surprised me because now he can't really tech up. He's getting an evolution chamber, but now yeah, that actually, means...
Yeah, that having that Evo chamber is going to be pretty pivotal. I mean, it's basically going to be able to get him, allow him to get detection for the DTs.
I know, but I don't know if he saw that, so he might have just gotten the evolution chamber just because he needed it or wanted it, but I'm not sure if he got it, but he is putting down spore crawlers, and yeah, single spore crawler on each one, and a nice amount of spine crawlers should destroy 5 DTs.
Yeah, see, I don't get what Link of Shadow is going here, or going for here. I mean, he, like, why get 5 gateways now? He's got so many gateways, but he hasn't really been able to produce out of all of them. I mean, he's gonna be able to make
2 DTs yeah. and 2 stalkers.
Yeah, but see, he could have been producing, like, he wasn't producing units constantly, right? So if he'd been producing units constantly, he could have produced that many units over the same amount of time with just 4 gateways. I don't think having 5 gateways is actually benefiting him.
Oh, an Archon actually going down.
That's what I figured was gonna happen. I wasn't completely sold on the fact that he was gonna try and catch his opponent off guard. Obviously, having those 5 gateways makes this extremely all-in, so he is going to be able to reinforce, but I still feel like he could have done this same push with only
now,
4 gateways.
Now, what I wanted to say is that if he had scouted the Zerg, just like the Zerg is scouting the Protoss aggressively, if he had scouted him, he would have noticed that all he really needed were... Whoa, never mind.
So many Spinecrawlers here. He's actually playing quite
good. However, there's this little opening right down here. If he can push through this or just walk in here... I don't know if he can necessarily walk through there, but he could definitely break this down with this large force.
Yeah, that's definitely one of the weaker points of the Zerg army. But
a large amount of Zerg.
He's playing a very Spanishiwa style, where basically he's holding off on Gath. Normally would have taken a third already, but detecting that is going to be some sort of one base all in by not seeing the Protoss expand at all.
Spine crawlers are really effective, especially with a triple queen transfusion force.
Yeah, I mean, these spine crawlers are not going to go down. So much damage being outputted by these spine crawlers.
Let's take a look at the amount of money lost.
Yeah, looking at the units lost tab, it's definitely in Zerg favor. Zerg has a large amount of harvester and gas income.
Oh, this right here might be a little... Oh, no, it's not. But once he does break through that, he's going to be able to walk... Oh, nope, not with the queen wall here and this little spine crawler walling off.
Link of Shadow might be able to... Zerglings are coming down, but they are going to be trapped here, and that spine crawler not even attempting to plant. I don't think it can plant, actually, on that ramp. We do see Zealots attempting to break the line here, but, I mean, Ryugu is going to have enough queens and spine crawler. I mean, there's no way that these units can actually break all those spine crawlers, so I feel like Ryugu, even if his main base were to go down, he would actually still be ahead if he just transferred all of his drones to
But it looks like the otherwise is gonna happen, and he's going to destroy his army, but he did lose a lot of spine crawlers. Now, I don't know who... I have a feeling the Zerg might have lost more minerals than the, Protoss did.
No, not even. We do see that, Protoss is heavily invested in this. This wasn't all-in, but I still don't get what he was trying to go for with this all-in. I mean, focusing down the Evo chamber, and what's that gonna do? Prevent him from
This one's pumping.
Yeah.
So
he does know that there is some sort of upgrade in production here, but I mean,
he can destroy it, but he's gonna get destroyed by these Lings.
Just gonna try and take it out. Nope, he might just lose all these stalkers. Link of Shadow, you saw there, was getting quite a bit frustrated. I wouldn't be surprised to see him leave this game very soon. All the units in the main base having been destroyed. We see the stalkers that were here to reinforce are having to run back. The macro of Link of Shadow was not that great during that battle. He could have been kept his money a lot lower, especially with those 5 gateways. 4 gateways can barely even be produced on...
Oh, that probe there was sitting there and put down a pylon.
Down here. Yeah, did make a proxy pylon.
And Zerg wonder why they get called overpowered. I wonder why Zerg get overpowered. They're not... Infestors,
I have to give this one to Ryugu. I feel like this was a bad one base all in.
No money and a that's no money of... indeed. He should have.
No money because he didn't expand.
And he was running like a ton of DTs coming out and stalkers. Yeah. 4 DTs off of one base. That's really crippling. Zerg here surprisingly having a ton of Vespeen. I'm not sure what he's trying to do.
Man.
I mean, build 1 billion spines and not care. That is true. He did in fact fast expand and did not even make any units. Just built spines. This was a good counter to his one base all in.
Yeah, definitely a really good response for Ryugu, because what he knows he's got more income than his opponent, so all he has to do is defend, and he basically wins.
Yeah, and this wall, so, this, I like the placement of the evolution chambers to draw the stalkers in. So they'll
provides more cover for the spine crawlers from Zealots.
Yeah, and they'll draw the stalkers in, and he can just have Lings run around and surround the stalkers. But
this is a really large push.
Yeah, large army. And he does have a couple of DTs. He's gonna make the Zerg build
a lot of spine crawlers. Those spine crawlers are insanely effective against.
However, just going down with this mass Ling army.
Yeah, the Lings and.
Is it +1/+1? Yes, yeah, they are.
Those upgrades did finish Link of Shadow feeling a little bit frustrated. saying he's way better and his opponent gets to win, but I don't know. I feel like his BM-iness was not warranted in this situation. Actually, a little bit of artifacting going on. I just realized everything's kind of flashing.
No, it was just at this point, I think. Oh yeah,
just it's... over in that section there. That's kind of weird.
All right, guys. Well, we did see a little bit of BMing at the end, which made this match really interesting. However. Don't go on ranting about how Zerg is so OP, because when you play Zerg, you can realize how underpowered they are.
For those of you
early
for those of you wondering, these were two master level players. Link of Shadow, I know, plays in some major, or he plays in a lot of online tournaments, because I know I've heard of him personally. But I mean, so he doesn't. I mean, I suppose he does know what he's talking about, but not in this circumstance. This was definitely an unwarranted call of BSiness. I mean, if you just look how wasteful, obviously, Link of Shadow is being with his units. I mean, down by 4,000 minerals, especially at this point in the game, definitely meant that it was I think it was his time to go in the game.
Yeah. All right, guys. This was, I guess, game one of one, Link Shadow versus Ryugu, and we'll be checking out.